Hello everyone, Dr. Polaris here. Before I get into the main subject of this video, I'd just like to give a big thank you to all my wonderful subscribers. The channel now has over 20,000 subs, a figure that has doubled in just a few months. So to commemorate this milestone, I've now created an account on Patreon, where you can sponsor my work and in return can watch ad-free versions of my videos before they're uploaded to YouTube. Also, I'll be holding polls where you, my loyal viewers, can decide the topics that'll be covered in upcoming videos. Feel free to head over to Patreon if you feel like supporting me, and once again, thank you for your continuing support. Now, onto the main topic of the video. Homotherini, also known as the scimitar-toothed cats, were a clade of machairodontine felids that achieved widespread success in the Neogene. The upper canines of these animals were comparatively shorter and flatter than those of Smilodon and its relatives, possessing steak knife-like serrations along the edges. Several genera were also rather cursorial terrestrial hunters, with elongated limbs and tails that were noticeably longer than those of other saber-toothed cats. Based on mitochondrial DNA analyses carried out on the fossils of the genus Homotherium, this lineage probably diverged from other Machairodontians roughly 18 million years ago, during the early Miocene. However, the oldest known fossils belonging to members of Homotherini date to approximately 10 million years ago, leaving something of a ghost lineage that may be filled by future discoveries. Five genera have been described and named, with the group inhabiting a massive range stretching across Eurasia, Africa, and the Americas, making it difficult to determine where Homotherini may have originated. The two most basal of these are also the oldest forms, both appearing quite suddenly during the late Miocene. The genus Nimravides was endemic to North America between approximately 10 and 5 million years ago. Despite the name, the animal was in no way closely related to the Nimravids, those superficially cat-like carnivorans that dominated the mammalian ambush hunting niche during the Eocene and Oligocene. Up to five species of Nimravides have been described, with remains recovered from Florida, Kansas, and much of the southwestern United States. The largest of these was N. catacopsis, which stood about 1 meter or 3.2 feet tall at the shoulder, being comparable to a modern lion or tiger in terms of size. In build, this cat was significantly lighter than these pantherines, however, possessing slender limbs and an elongated back and narrow skull. The tail was also much longer than in the far more robust Smilodon, which would have aided in balancing the animal while chasing after prey. These adaptations suggest a predator that spent a great deal of its time on the ground, pursuing camelids and pronghorns across open country in opposition to the robust contemporary Barbara felid, Barbara felis, which likely preferred more heavily wooded environments. Leggy, slender, and cursorial forms similar to Nimravides may have even been ancestral to Homotherini as a whole. The closely related genus Amphimacherodus was more widespread, inhabiting Eurasia, Africa, and North America between 9.5 and 5.3 million years ago. Again, up to five species were present across this range, with all being large, powerful predators. Unlike Nimravides, Amphimacherodus was an ambush predator with proportionally shorter limbs. The serrated upper canines were particularly robust and capable of handling a great degree of stress while slicing through the jugular of its prey. The Eurasian species, A. giganteus, was comparable to a Siberian tiger in terms of size. Fossil finds have demonstrated that the species was profoundly sexually dimorphic, with males being much larger than females, although interestingly the latter possessed longer and slimmer canines. Based on late Miocene fossil sites in Greece and China, A. giganteus dwelt in forested savanna ecosystems and hunted the antelope Tragoportax, the horse Hipparion, and juveniles of the proboscidean Anancus. The North American species A. coloradensis was generally larger, weighing in excess of 300 kilograms or 661 pounds, and standing almost 4 feet tall at the shoulder. However, the most massive species, and indeed one of the largest felids to ever exist, was the African Amphimacherodus kabir, which was native to northern Chad. This imposing animal was comparable to Eurasian cave lions in terms of size, and weighed up to 360 kilograms or almost 800 pounds, being one of the largest of the Machairodontines. A. kabir dwelt in a lush savanna ecosystem that bordered an extensive system of lakes and watering holes, which supported a diverse assemblage of animals. two additional genera of Machaerodontians were present, with both being substantially smaller predators. While potential prey included horses, giraffids, wild pigs, and the possible early human relative Sahelanthropus. One of the Machaerodonts that lived alongside A. kabir in late Miocene Chad was the genus Loctungylurus. A more derived member of Homotherini, this animal was about the same size as a lioness or a large male leopard, and possessed a slender build and long gracile limbs. Two species, L. emigaritus and L. fanonae, have been described, with their remains found in deposits dating to 7 million years ago. This cat also sported greatly enlarged dew claws in comparison to other Machaerodonts, suggesting that this feature was highly important in prey capture. It would have targeted smaller and faster prey than contemporary felids, such as antelopes and the more diminutive giraffids. Like the later genus Homotherium, Loctungylurus was a highly cursorial predator that was capable of chasing prey over long distances. In fact, an animal potentially very similar to Loctungylurus could have given rise to the two most derived members of Homotherini, namely Homotherium itself and the genus Xenosmilus. The latter was endemic to North America and ranged between the mid to late Pleistocene, surviving until about 300,000 years ago. Another massive and robust form, Xenosmilus was also among the largest of all Machaerodonts, potentially outweighing Amphimacherodus kabir at up to 400 kilograms or 880 pounds. This would make the cat only slightly smaller than Smilodon populator, which Xenosmilus would have resembled to some extent, although still possessing significantly shorter upper canines. Interestingly, all of this animal's teeth were serrated, not only the sabers, with researchers suggesting that the bite and retreat strategy might have been employed to weaken larger prey, such as juvenile mammoths and ground sloths. This has led to Xenosmilus receiving the nickname of the cookie cutter cat. A pair of specimens were discovered in Florida in the 1980s, leading to theories that this animal was social and hunted in small groups. The specimens were surrounded by disarticulated peccary bones, most likely being the remains of recent kills. Unlike its sister genus Homotherium, which seemingly continued to develop the cursorial adaptations of Loctungylurus, Xenosmilus evolved in the opposite direction, becoming a stout-legged and highly muscular ambush predator that inhabited the forests of the American South rather than the open mammoth steppe. As mentioned in a previous video, Homotherium was the last member of this clade, surviving until the Pleistocene-Holocene boundary. With its passing, the clade Homotherini became extinct along with all Machaerodontine felids, with some of their niches filled by members of the genus Panthera. Still, these saw-toothed, sometimes pursuit-hunting predators have no direct modern counterparts, being a unique product of their time. Thanks for watching, everyone. The next episode will cover the Ambelodontids, the so-called Shovel-Tusker Proboscideans. See you again soon. Cheerio.